Okay.
Oh, that was sweet.
A few nice words from Mandy Moore there. Welcome back.
That was really
NSYNC,
nice,
the road to celebrity. Carson Daly in San Diego with NSYNC. Chillin' tailgate style. We're right outside the stadium where the guys are going to play just a little bit later tonight in front of about 50,000 screaming fans. And so many people have come out today, they've even converted some of their cars into gasoline-powered NSYNC posters. Let's take a look at some of these cars that came out to our little tailgate party. We've narrowed it down to five. You guys will select one of these cars, and that winner, the owner of that car, is going to get an upgrade to world-class VIP seating for tonight's concert. So there's one there.
Looking like a heat.
Wow.
Yeah, all right, let's check out this one here.
That's a
look at your face. Your face.
Your face.
NSYNC
your face.
Fans. Look at your let me see inside. Can we get in there?
Oh, wow.
Oh, yeah. Look
at the shrine. Holy. Nice.
McDonald's and all.
Wow, nice. All right, let's see the next one.
Okay, let's check this out. Nice.
Uh-oh, the Vanna White.
Palm
I love
tree.
It.
Yeah. It's funny. They already have the celebrity album on the front hood. How did they get that?
What is that?
Oh, yeah.
What?
Even wait, I got to see that Joey doll on the hood. Can we go close to
tree? Down in the front?
Yeah, let's see that thing.
Oh, oh Lord. That,
pretty sure that's
tripping me out a little bit.
I knew it!
Wow. Yo, it's got a monkey and a hairy chest. Okay, put the monkey away.
Oh, for the love of Pete.
Where's the jello?
Okay, let me see the next car.
Oh, there wow. Wow.
Well, that's pretty good.
Some of the highlights.
Can't even see
car.
Their headlights.
No.
Yeah, like,
what is it, Mardi Gras?
Beat.
Like,
Mardi Gras!
Wrong way.
Jump up, okay, have fun.
Wow.
And here's the final one.
What's how long is it going to take to clean off?
I hope there's no duct tape involved.
How do you drive with that stuff?
Oh, there you
that's watch out for
cool.
Low bridges.
That's pretty cool on the hood.
That's hot.
Okay, so they're there.
That's hot.
There are the five right there.
That's cool.
Nice work. We'll have a winner in just a little bit.
Cool.
You know, there comes a point in your career where we really start making money. No. There comes a point where you have to start.
Just tell us when that is.
You have to really lighten up. People start to poke fun at you. It seems like the bigger you get, the more you're, you know,
parroting. We've always had to
fight for everything that we've got. You know, when we first started, you know, everybody was like, there's no way it's going to make it over here. That's why we had to sign in Europe first. Then when we came over here, people said, no way. And we ended up doing, you know, a show on Disney. And then we ended up, you know, Janet Jackson was nice enough to ask us to open up for her. She's a wonderful lady. And every night we'd go out there. And when we walked out there in the beginning of the show, we'd get booed. We'd walk out to boos. But by the end...
Wait. No, this is
the uplifting parts. But by the end of our performance, we had the crowd.
Like
and we always fought for the crowd all the way through. And, you know, we're always good to our fans. And that's, you know, and that's kind of, we've always had to deal with fighting for everything we get. And we don't mind fighting, you know, now. So.
But it's safe to say now that you're, you know, being so huge and everything, you still don't take yourself that serious.
No,
we don't take
ourselves that serious.
Well, I mean, just the fact that we can, you know, we remember things like that. We came from very humble beginnings, you know, and you never forget that no matter how big of a status people think that you have. I mean, that's why we picked a title like celebrity, because we don't really look at ourselves as celebrities, you know.
Right.
We look at ourselves as everyday people, so it's kind of like a tongue-in-cheek kind of thing.
Yeah.
Plus, I mean, we always make fun of ourselves. I mean, with the
especially you.
Live,
yeah,
especially
me. But he does it accidentally.
It just happens.
Let's check this thing out we got right here. Is there just some highlights, a little medley of people poking fun at NSYNC?
Yeah. Oh, no, not at us.
Or as I like to call them, the Spice Boys. I don't want to see you out that door, baby, bye-bye-bye.
You have to replace any of the NSYNC members with my brother Marlon. If you had to, right?
Yeah.
Who would you lose?
I can't do that.
What about the dude with the Tickle Me Elmo hair, the red hair?
No.
Hey, it's great to be back here in New York City, all right, hey.
All right, what about the nice one that looked like a sweet version of Eminem?
Do people still use rotary dial phones?
All right, fine. Forget you. I don't want to be in the group anyway. I'm going to start my own. Really, in rhythm.
If they get the question right, Danielle is going to stick them with an NSYNC picture sticker. Hey, remember when you were on TRL? What hat were you wearing? NSYNC is worse than NSYNC.
No, it's not. We're NSYNC, not NSYNC.
America's hottest boy band, NSYNC, wants to be in the movie business, but it hasn't been... Who wants to see a f***ing NSYNC movie anyway?
That would be a politically incorrect statement to make.
I never saw that.
There you go.
See that Eminem thing.
You never saw the Eminem thing, Chris?
No. He beat us to it.
Let's get to our next Arsus classic. This was at the 1999 MTV Movie Awards, and there's a scene in this that is so funny when you guys were doing the Armageddon thing. You're actually poking fun at yourselves with Lisa Kudrow. This is great. It's moment number six. Watch this.
A world under fire.
It's a giant asteroid.
That's not an asteroid. It's an asterisk.
My God, it's enormous.
Seems to have dislodged from the talented girl group Bewitched. It's gaining momentum, and it's hurtling towards Earth.
And only one group can put the planet back.
It's tearing up my heart.
In sync.
Gentlemen, we need their high-spirited boy pop. We've got 18 days to harness the power of their apostrophe to stop the asterisk. In sync's our only hope. Plus, I've always wanted to meet JC.
You will be experiencing zero gravity.
This may be devastating to your footwork.
Who's the leader of the group?
Leader? There's no I in NSYNC.
Sometimes, the only ones who can save humanity...
We have 18 minutes to zero barrier.
...are the dreamiest white boys on Earth.
We may not have much experience driving your fancy rocket mobiles or blowing up asteroids, but when it comes to popping fresh dance moves, this is the best ragtag group of pretty boys on the planet.
This is the greatest.
You know what I was thinking?
What?
I don't think an animal cracker really qualifies as a cracker.
Why?
Well, putting cheese on something is sort of a defining characteristic of what makes a cracker a cracker.
I don't like this. I said stop it. Ow. I'm sorry. You're so cute.
Thanks.
Hey, NSYNC?
Yeah?
Do you think that somewhere in the world there's another boy group doing this very same thing at this very same moment?
I hope so. Otherwise, what the hell are we trying to save?
I hope so, too. Otherwise, what the hell are we trying to save?
Yeah, me too. Otherwise, what the hell are we trying to...
Okay, jeez! I'm sorry I asked. And I said stop it, okay? It's not sexy. Trust me.
This summer, get on a collision course with Boylicious. Armageddon's sake.
There you have it. That was great. Moment number six.
That was funny.
We'll move right into moment number five. At this point, it's mid-2000. No Strings Attached just demolishes all record sales. Over 2 million copies in a week. You've already performed on the award shows. You performed on the Academy Awards at this point. And now it's the MTV Movie Awards. And your fans voted this at number five. Let's watch it and talk about it. Play it down, NSYNC moment number five.